yet?
I got a question about, like, amplitude.
Yeah.
So I always struggle with, like, how wide to make it, like, really short.
Yeah.
Or really wide, and how that affects that.
Yeah.
I was getting asked, like, with, like, supplementing on that, like, to set up your dolphin kick, I've always been, like, do a couple big and then getting shorter, faster.
Yeah.
To set it up. Like, I don't know, is that wrong, or is that...
Well, essentially, the larger the amplitude is a couple things, more power than your drag.
Yeah.
So if you're pushing off the wall and you think about it, you're going to be at your highest speed.
Right.
So why do you want to increase your drag, and also why do you want to try to create more power in that specific instance? So the reality is it should probably be inverted.
Okay.
It should be a smaller amplitude getting to bigger as you're about to break out.
Okay.
So that way you're really actually trying to keep that speed as high as possible, and then you're minimizing your drag and put it to the very, very beginning. Because the reality is with amplitude, when I think about kicking in general, I think a lot of people always say, like, run from the 90-degree knee bend. And that is just a way overemphasis of what actually happens. Like, on freestyle kick, I always say it's, like, the same amount of knee bend as you have when you walk, which is about 120 degrees. Dolphin kick, you might get a little bit closer towards the bum, maybe 150 or so. But it's still not very large. So overall, when you look at the amplitude, if you're looking at the body line, you're probably coming up to about 40 degrees above and then about 40 degrees below, so it's really not that wide.
So like a window of like 2
essentially. Because you kind of still want to keep it through what would be like,
through, like
the
next two, year. Yeah.
Yeah. So when I grew up, it was always like kick through the tunnel, the pipes, hit
right.
Both sides, but making sure that you're going through up